Thank you for the invitation to give a presentation of my company. I do it with my charming assistant, Marie Fleur, because I really need assistance to do this. Yeah, we have a three parts presentation. First one is I want to show you what the name has become. We relaunched because we are an interior and lighting design office. And we design healthy surroundings, healthy environments for hospitals, for schools, for nursery homes. That's our main, those are the main projects. And, but our name was Colormark, Kleurmerk. So when we sit on the table with installators, with technical people, and you come with Colormark, they, you had to prove that you knew something, know something about lights, know really something about light, about healthy lights, and about biophilic interiors. So the name didn't fit what we do anymore. And that's why we said a year ago, we want to rebrand, find a new name, and a new presentation of the company. And that's happened last Thursday, 3rd of October. I first will show you how the name was developed, how it's where it came from. Then I show you a short video, both a few minutes, of our company presentation. And at the end, I will show you live here our expo room, because what we think is you can talk a lot about light and about healthy light, healthy surroundings, healthy environment. But this is by the best way to tell about is to show it. So we developed an expo room in which we can show what light can do with you in very ugly space, to be honest. It used to be very ugly. We made it better. So I'll show you first a video of what we made of the name. Is this okay? As the world's population grew, nature was increasingly changed for urbanization. This is the translation of the lines in the video. As a result, we spent more and more time between four walls. And this shift makes it essential to reintroduce nature into our built spaces to enhance the well-being of those who inhabit them. It is in our nature to design with biophilic design for spaces and for lights with biodynamic lights. Sorry. From October the 3rd, from now on, we are Studio LRO, Natural Light and Space Design. So that was the explanation for the name rebranding.
Anna, we can't see you.
But that was the explanation for the rebranding in the name. Yeah, Hero Face again. I go right on with the presentation of the company, and then we go to the expo space, and we you can ask questions. Okay. So, yeah.
You did switch on the sound.
Yes, we did.
Licht en interieur hebben heel veel invloed op ons welbevinden. Zowel voor onze kinderen op school, als voor ouderen in de zorg, als voor jou en mij. En de verbinding te zoeken met de natuur maakt dat mensen beter gaan slapen en zich prettiger voelen en ook beter geconcentreerd aan hun werk kunnen beginnen. Wij zijn Studio LRO, licht- en ruimteontwerp met een natuurlijke basis. Wij verbinden mensen met de natuur, omdat dat onze oorsprong is. En op het moment dat die verbinding is gelegd, dan zijn we energieker, we slapen beter en we gaan eigenlijk met meer plezier naar het werk. Daar zit niks zweverigs aan. Het is harde wetenschap en binnen 8 dagen kun je al eigenlijk een effect sorteren door het installeren van een biodynamische lichtinstallatie. Licht en interieur zijn voor ons onlosmakelijk met elkaar verbonden. Op het moment dat je het licht aandoet, verandert je interieur en andersom. Dus die twee die horen samen. We hebben een dubbele expertise binnen Studio LRO en vinden dat we dat ook heel serieus met elkaar samen moeten laten gaan. Na 25 jaar volle ervaring met lichtontwerp en interieurontwerp, dus zijn een volwaardige partner voor onze opdrachtgevers. En heel belangrijk daarbij is, we hebben het niet over smaak, want we vertrekken vanuit de natuur.
I hope you enjoyed the video, the relaunch of our company, and I hope that the message we try to bring very clearly is that we need to combine, to bring in the nature in the human being, and we can do that by with biodynamic lights and with biophilic interiors. That's what our main course is. And what I said in the beginning, that we can talk a lot about it, but it's better to show what we mean. And we have a lot of discussions with clients about why does light has to cost so much? And what's the difference between spot one and spot two? And what is biodynamic lighting? How does it look like? So we designed an expo space in which we can show all the steps that we integrate in our lighting and interior designs. And this was an area which was ugly. It had a blue carpet. It had only a few spots, and that was it. And I think it's an area in which a lot of us stay in, work in nowadays still. So it was the best area we could, environment we could redesign. So, I'm leaving you now. Marie-Fleur will make a video of me, and I'm going to show you. It is a sneak preview because there is a lot in this expo space. Jan has already seen the expo space, so I can talk to you about this space about 3 hours. But that won't work. I do it in a few minutes. Sneak preview. I put off the lights and put on the lights as we started with this environment, with this room, and show you a few light scenes in which we can show you what it can do and how it can change the feeling in the room. Besides, of course, that it's biodynamic and healthy introduced also. Important to say that in the room, there is no dark daylight. So it's in the basement. Better
uitgangspunt.
Starting point we didn't have. So
this is the room in which we started, our starting point. And we had only spotlights like this, very bright lights, very sharp lights. And you can see what it does on the floor. So we were looking for spots, for example, that has a more friendly view, is comfortable for the eye, and gives more light at the same time. So now I have to search for this one. You can see, and when you look at the ceiling, we have used different spots, and we have far more light on the floor, and the light in the ceiling is comfortable. So there are big changes between one spot and the other. Just a sneak preview of what you can reach by changing the source of the lumina. What we also have, we have six islands, and we have one bad, soft island, and we have a good, soft island. And it is not about luminous, because we don't sell luminous, we sell vision. But what we want to show you, and I show you this one, is, for example, this one. You have two downlighters, which we use a lot in offices, in hospitals, and wherever. And one downlighter keeps the light up in the ceiling and has a very sharp light for the eyes, uncomfortable, especially people who have elderly people who have problems with light and darkness changes. They have problems with this sort of light. When we change the downlighter into another optic, we have more light on the floor and more comfort for the eye. So good island and a bad island. We have a lot of examples here where we can show. This is what you can see. But we have a lot of discussions with our clients about the prices. Why does this one cost 45 euros? And why does that one cost 145 euros, for example? You cannot see it. Well, this time you can see it, obvious, but the other one in the middle, you can't see it. But there are a lot of differences in the technical specifications, which makes the one more expensive than the other one. And but a client really can't show and tell you the difference. So in this area, we help them to see and discover what the differences are and why do you pay 45 for the one and 145 for the other one. So now what we also show, of course, is what color does with materials. So we have different CRI values where we can show what changes in the color. And this is especially when we design with interior, that really surprises our clients. They were not aware of the big differences you can reach with that. So that was another example. Then we have, let me see, we work with indirect lights and with biophilic lights. So what I did now was added indirect light by the Petfeld ceiling in the stairs, in the ceilings, in the aisles, and we put a vision, because we have no daylight here, in the back of the room. So this makes the room, the sphere in the room, totally different, and works very well when we want to have a meeting or something else. It gives a good feel. But of course, we will also want to have healthy lights. That's the last one I want to show you. Healthy lights. Here we have an example of how we can design healthy lights. And I can show you, of course, what it does with the color change, the temperature and the lumen. I believe, Jan, you made measurements during the expo on the 3rd of October. And we measured vertical lights, about 2,600, I believe. And this one is pleasant because it has a large diameter. So what we say is, when you add light into the area, and it has to be more and more because we want to have more light, then use optics that are larger or go indirect in the area. And it comes, the same strength of lumen output comes from a small diameter is unpleasant for the eye. So we change the colors, we change the lux values, and we create indirect light. We have also an example. This one. Because when it comes from the indirect, and we now just are finally finishing a school in Nijmegen, where we have in the classrooms this solution of bringing the light indirect in the school, added with also other light luminous, of course, but to show you how you can create, still affordable because schools don't have very much money, but how you can create a good lighting environment and a healthy lighting environment also in schools. So this is what we do. I cannot tell you a lot more about this Expora space, but the coffee is hot here. So if you are interested, you're welcome. And I now go to the healthy outline totally. So this is what we do.
Okay, thank you, Erna. Great, great overview of your showroom. I have to say that it was impressive, especially if you look at the showroom in person. Yeah, that gives a much better impression than watching it through a camera, because the camera flattens everything out. Yeah, but we could see the especially the color difference and the intensity differences that are made. Yeah, so. And you have been your whole life or most of your life in lighting design and interior design, you know, combine it. And I have the idea that you know, fully focus on the health aspects of indoor light. So it's great to have you in the group. You're one of the first people that joined as a participant. At least I wish you a lot of luck with your new branding of your studio. And for all the participants, Anna is mainly a lighting or interior advisor. Huh? She doesn't sell per se products or so. She gives the advice to customers.
We make the design. We make the measurements with Dialux. So we do everything what you need to get a good lighting plan and of course a good interior plan. Yeah.
Okay. We have a couple of minutes left for questions. Are there somebody have a question for Erna? I don't see hands. Or do I see hands? No questions? No, I don't think so.
Jan, I got one question.
Okay. Who is this? Who's speaking?
Yeah, Jan, hoor je mij?
Yeah, I hear you.
I'm John Kallik of Ronald. I got one question regarding what Erna just showed us. In respect to uniformity and unified glare rate. If you do like schools and we see more and more notebooks arriving in schools and some sort of stuff, how do you cope with the unified glare rate in schools?
Well, in this case, because it's indirect light, it's a very low factor, low rate, because it comes from the ceiling. And the added luminous, because it's not the only thing, the ceiling, we added luminous, they have a good rate below the 19 and sometimes even 17, I think, in this example. So that's very important, of course. And we also think that's not in the classifications, the hoe zeg je dat? Goede schoolclassificatie.
De NEN-norms.
Ja, in de NEN-norm. is that we also designed that for the central areas because the laptops are everywhere.
Yeah.
Very important issue.
Okay. Any other question? If not, you can always contact Anna directly.
Yep. Oh, yes, I have a final one.
Oh, Maarten, go ahead.
First, compliments. Very good, Anna. You're leading the pack. So many organizations are struggling to go to LED solutions from fluorescent to LED. In Dutch, they call it verledder. It's not a great word, but anyhow, it's being used. So how do you persuade your decision makers in these projects to go to run the extra mile, to make the next step, not only go to LED, but then go to healthy or biophilic design? Mm-hmm. I think that's probably a challenge. And I was just wondering, maybe you have some tips for us how to... persuade these parties fast and correct.
Well, it's very hard, and you know that very well, I think, to get numbers on the table of that you can reduce costs by per health.
Absenteeism.
It's very hard to make that hard. Take that as an evidence on the table. No, my real life experience is that you just need on the right level in the organization one person who believes that this works, and this one person makes the decision. Because what we did is with a few clients is we made clear how big the part is of the lighting in the total cost of building and in the total cost of engineering electrician. And then light solves in that because it's such a small part. And to make that clear that it's a small part and has a great effect, that's what I tell about 10 times a day.
Yeah, and apparently you're successful, huh? Because you have many clients and more schools and care homes and so on.
We only do biodynamic lighting. But it's not in a building like in a hospital. Not everywhere, of course. We now work for a psychiatrist company, mental psychiatrist patients. Very specific. And we design biodynamic lighting in the living rooms, for example, at the areas where they are the most. And then we roll out a lighting plan with good lines of sight, with good lines of sight. And the combination with the biophilic interior. So that is what you can do everywhere, to have a good lighting plan with good lighting sites, and in specific areas you add the biodynamic dimension. So that also makes it costable, affordable.